ministry project at the campus, and my team and I screwed up the soup one night, and 150 people didn't get to eat lunch the next day. That was a mistake that I still kind of regret. So my mission from that point on was to serve the homeless. I graduated college and went to Washington, D.C., landed there, and lived with a community called So Others Might Eat. It started in the 70s as a soup kitchen, and it's now a multi-million dollar, several hundred program agency. It still exists. The priest who ran it back then is still there. And I learned at that soup kitchen not only the importance of health care, mental health care, and dental care, but transitional housing, wraparound services, and coaching and mentoring, as well as keeping the facility looking like new. My internship that summer, they paid me $25 a month, and I was their landscaper, carpenter, plumber, electrician, and also helped out in the soup kitchen. I also locked up their abused and neglected homeless elderly shelter at night. So that's where I started. Graduate school, I focused on prison systems and transitional programs after that, because so many of the people in the streets were former criminals or vets. And started working in the streets. I was a workaholic. I worked for DC government as well as Catholic Charities. And the Catholic Charities program was brand new. It was called St. Vincent de Paul. It's in my resume. And I was a social worker there, helping crack addicted homeless men, several of whom were also found to be HIV positive when HIV was brand new. And that's where my career started in social work. And fast forward, marrying a Navy man and living all over the world, raising money for the poor everywhere we lived, as well as children and schools everywhere we lived, because I had to put my career on a shelf. But I kept fundraising and I kept active and I kept doing things for whatever community we landed in. And our last duty station was here. My husband was transferred from Naples, Italy to Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. I bought our house online down in Fort Orange, moved here with two kids, and my first summer here, a homeless man was beaten to death in the streets of Daytona. And I asked my kids and my husband, where have we come? And for the last 12 years, I've been behind the scenes, because I've also gotten a PhD since moving here, working full-time, being a mom, being a wife. But I have been one of those people who feeds the homeless when we're not supposed to. I've already procured dental care equipment from a dentist. Whenever Health Exec Ministries wants to start a dental clinic, it's being stored at Stuart Marchman. And I have focused my work the last 12 years on the opiate problem. I was chair of the Substance Abuse Task Force. And that's what my dissertation was about, advocacy efforts and how to make change in a community. I also trained law enforcement officers. I've been doing that for 10 years. Role-playing mental illness. It's not an easy thing to do, but crisis intervention training at the Flagler and Volusia Sheriff's Office, as well as the Daytona Beach Police Department. I started doing that back in 2008 when Stuart Marchman merged with ACT. Because of the incidents of homeless and mentally ill folks getting shot to death. So I role play to help train law enforcement how to deal